We use engineering to describe very complicated systems, satellites, large ecosystems. Why don't we use the same tools to try to understand the brain? When I pick it up, your hand moves up a little bit. But when you pick it up, it remains absolutely steady. When you do something, your brain predicts what's going to be the consequences of it. And that prediction is a computation that is performing. Through practice, it's learned physics. What we just saw was that the brain predicts things, and based on its prediction, it can maintain control. We've learned over the years that this comes from a specific part of the brain, the cerebellum. For every movement we make, we need the cerebellum. I really had two problems to solve. The first problem was, when you just normally move, what is the cerebellum doing? But then when you learn to do something new, how does it add to it? And to do that, we had to study neurons in the brain. We have been able to describe a model with which we can understand certain properties of neurons in the cerebellum. And we remain hopeful that by allowing us to use the model to decode the activity, we've taken the first step in understanding how learning takes place. Diseases that affect the brain result in almost always some form of a movement disorder. And when there's damage to the cerebellum, people really struggle in ordinary things. The implication of our work is that it's possible to make headway in understanding how did this come about. And that's really the promise of neuroengineering, is that if you understand the system well enough, you can diagnose simply by watching people the specific location where something has gone wrong. And then perhaps if you know how that part functions, you would also know what should we do to repair it. Being at Johns Hopkins, I have colleagues that look at individuals who have damage to the nervous system, clinicians who treat patients. I have computational resources that allow me to explore the function of the brain. This ability to look at the problem from different angles with expertise that come from different directions, I think is the key to understand something as complicated as the brain. And Hopkins provides a medical school, an engineering school, fantastic students, excellent resources, all together at a place that allows you to make discovery.